Greetings, Eric Bakker. Thanks for coming back and checking out my videos again. I've been on YouTube now for a few years. I'm getting some great feedback from people, awesome feedback, and lots of people are getting amazing results just by following some of the simple instructions in my videos. These aren't really complicated videos. They're simple videos based on my 30 plus years of experience and also based on common sense, okay? Something not very common today with smartphones and a lot of dumb people and a lot of smart technology out there. But I'm not saying you're dumb. I'm just saying that you've got to think along simple lines, basic lines, what's really going to help you with your problem. So today we're going to talk about why you'll likely never get rid of SIBO by relying on antibiotics, whether it's amoxicillin or, you know, Rifaximin or Xifaxin or any kind of drug like that. These are all drugs. There are a lot of naturopaths, not so much in the Southern Hemisphere, but in the US, that prescribe Rifaximin. Since I've been working online through FaceTime and Skype, I've had lots and lots and lots of people I've seen, hundreds and hundreds, that have taken Rifaximin with minimal result. Some got initially a result and then they regressed. They had to go back on this Rifaximin again because it doesn't really get absorbed well in the gut. It acts in the gut and you pass it out. So it's not really good for anything except a small bowel kind of a problem. But I've got a bit of stuff written on paper here, so I want to spend a bit of time with you today explaining to you why, in my experience, relying on antibiotics for SIBO is a complete waste of time in most cases. Okay, because you're taking your eye off the ball. You're thinking this drug is going to cure all my problems, all my hydrogen and methane issues in my gut are all going to be resolved with this drug. Well, it ain't going to happen in most cases. You may get a partial, you know, it's like giving a teenager a cash advance. It feels great initially, but then, bang, they're back to square one again. And that's my experience in most cases that I've seen taking an antibiotic for SIBO. Now, let's explain a few reasons why I'm making this statement. All right. Number one, you're not really looking at all your options. So your naturopath may say to you, for example, look, this drug's going to work. You've shown a high level of methane or hydrogen in your breath test. You know, we've done a breath test on you. It's clearly obviously got SIBO, and now we're going to cure it with this drug. So the patient thinks, wow, all my problems are over. This drug is going to cure me. But did you look at all your herbal options before you went into antibiotics? Because remember, Rifaximin works on gram-positive and negative bacteria in the small intestine. It doesn't generally make it to the large. It cleans the slate. It can wipe out a whole lot of other stuff apart from the SIBO bacteria you're looking at. It's not necessarily going to just target SIBO, okay? So that's my concern. Herbal options tend to be, in my opinion, more broad spectrum. You're looking at a wider range of bacteria, but not only that, you're also going to target SIFO or small intestinal fungal overgrowth. Because these antibiotics do nothing for fungal, they only target bacteria. So all you're doing is you're looking at one particular little tiny thing in the gut that you're trying to work on, but the gut's more complex than that. In my opinion, most all people I see when I do stool testing, and I've done thousands of these tests, have got imbalances across the board, okay? They will have some fungal issues. Many have parasites these days. Many have got issues with low pancreatic enzyme output. They're going to have low secretory IgA or poor immune function. They're going to have bowel imbalances, no, colon imbalances, small intestine imbalances. So there'll be imbalances all across the board. So in my opinion, giving most people with SIBO just an antibiotic is not going to be really helping with all of these issues. It's not individual enough for the patient. Your clinician, naturopath or functional medicine doctor, really is best to do by doing a proper functional stool test to see what the heck's going on with your gut. A three-day stool test, day one, two, and three. Three samples done properly, you need proper instructions on how to do it. That's going to show where the real problems are. And then likely you'll get a susceptibility panel showing you what agents to target those bacteria or fungus that are specific for your need, okay? Not what your clinician thinks, oh, well, let's give this a try for 10 days, okay? It's not good enough, all right? So look at all your herbal options and also especially think about testing not just the breath test. Do the comprehensive digestive stool analysis, all right? This will give you all the range of what we're really talking about. You'll get a full comprehensive picture. When you buy a house, okay, you get a full, you should, in my opinion, get a full inspection done by someone who's good, who checks the house out from the top to the bottom, you know, the basement, everything's checked. I did that with this old clunger that I bought here, but the builder's working at the moment on the kitchen. And I was shocked to find out how much rot there was in the roof, okay, which was great because I got it at a better price. So it pays to poke your nose into areas where maybe, you know, you don't think you should be poking them in. So testing's the big one, all right? So likely you're not testing for co-infections. So if your practitioner has only performed a SIBO breath test, it's not enough, especially if you've got a long-term ongoing gut or skin issue or some type of health problem for many years. You need to do the stool test alongside the breath test, all right? Number two, or number three, you're paying lip service to probiotics. So probiotics in some cases work far superior than antibiotics. There are many studies now that prove that probiotics in some cases out-trump, okay? It's a better solution for some patients that I've seen than taking any anti-product as a pro-product. And again, a stool test will show us that. If you're showing really low levels or nil growth counts of lactobacillus and bifidobacteria, and you're showing some SIBO there, in some cases, the probiotics are far more important than looking at the antibiotic, all right? You think that SIBO is just about killing the bad guys. It's not, all right? SIBO is not just about killing, it's also about building. And when you're taking an antibiotic, I can't understand why naturopaths use antibiotics, in my opinion, because it's just not really conducive towards pro-life, is it? So another issue that's often overlooked is the poor migrating motor complex, or MMC. So this is something that cleans up the small bowel between meals, all right? There are various hormones that come into play with the MMC, and particularly the vagal tone, so the vagus nerve, the parasympathetic nerve has a big effect on this migrating motor complex. Now, if you've got sympathetic dominance through stress, you're going to have parasympathetic depression or an imbalance. It's going to give you weak vagal tone. It's going to give you poor MMC. It's going to give you bloating, gas, all those kind of problems. Antibiotics are going to do squat for a poor vagal tone. Okay. So if you're suffering from a crappy job, a stressful relationship, you're not happy, you can feel stressed, or you're pissed about something, or you've got adrenal issues. This is what needs sorting, people, not just popping a pill for 10, 14 days to kill off the bugs, okay? Maybe you need to kill off the boss. Maybe you need to kill off the dead relationship. Maybe something else needs killing apart from bacteria. I'm not suggesting to go out and get an assault rifle and, you know, take everyone out. I'm suggesting look at your life, at your relationships, at how you feel. If something's not right, fix it up, okay? Antibiotics aren't going to do anything for a crappy relationship, are they? All right. HPA axis dysfunction. This is stress, sympathetic dominance. When you are stressed, your digestive output goes south, right? That means the peristalsis, or ability to move stool through the gut's compromised. The ability for your body to make proper stomach and pancreatic enzymes is compromised. Even your blood chemistry changes. Your liver chemistry changes, your kidney chemistry changes, everything changes under stress. So if you suffer from stress because of poor health, don't think the antibiotic is going to cure your problem. In my opinion, from where I'm sitting, from all the people I've seen, the lifestyle trumps just about anything else in your life, including your diet, all right? I'm coming to the end of my consultancy work now. I'm retiring in November this year, so I can spend more time doing this kind of work, to work with thousands of people online. I don't need money. I mean, I've got other companies I'm involved in now, so I love the clinic. I really enjoy it, and I love helping people, but I get annoyed at seeing people spend money on things they don't need to spend on, going from doctor to doctor to doctor, taking prescription after prescription and getting nowhere, all right? And often it's because of lack of information, not understanding the full extent of your condition, or thinking you can just pop a pill to quickly cure something and then get back on the saddle again. It doesn't work like that, all right? And one of the last points, which is a very cool one, is not looking at structural issues that affect people. I had an interesting case of a law enforcement officer from the States not that long ago who was having very weird bowel motions, strange, lots of gut pain. And the medical specialist said he's got a rare form of some type of a mast cell disease or something affecting his gut. I said to him, come on, man, common things happen to people commonly. I don't think you've got a rare kind of disease. And then I found out that he's wearing one of these holsters around his waist with a handgun, you know, and pepper spray stuff and all that stuff these policemen wear, you know, all this sort of stuff, handcuffs and I don't know what. And that would weigh umpteen pounds. He had a low-grade back pain. The chiropractor basically fixed up his 11th and 12th thoracic vertebrae, which, of course, supplied nerve supply to the small bowel, and bingo, he's pooping again. Common sense. You know what I'm saying? Common sense. Think about your occupation. Think about your life. Don't think that antibiotic is going to cure SIBO. It's not in most cases. You need to look further afield. Have a listen again to this video if you need to the tips, because I think there will be some useful ones in here for you. Thanks for tuning in and give us some comments.